As the barn doors slowly creaked open, revealing a thick layer of dust and cobwebs, the auctioneers' minds likely began to race at the prospect of what they were about to discover. But even they probably couldn't have imagined the full extent of what the long-abandoned barn contained. Their find was as rare as it was awe-inspiring. The barn on the Danish island of Zealand fell into the possession of a local auction house in 2015. So intrigued by what might be inside, a group of experts by camp and auctioneer immediately headed off to find out. History beckoned. After the owner of the property had passed away, the barn and its contents had been turned over to the auction house. And by the time the team came to open it up, it hadn't been touched in nearly 15 years. But while the auctioneers had an inkling of what might be inside the building, they didn't know for sure exactly what they'd find. Still, as soon as the barn came into their possession, they couldn't wait to see. And so the auctioneers promptly headed off to investigate its contents. In fact, the team were so excited that they wasted absolutely no time. In a video detailing the find, the auction house director, Finn Campen, said, "Usually I always sleep well, but tonight I only had 3 hours, and then up at 4 a.m. to get here." So when they finally pushed open those creaking doors on that morning in October of 2015, the excitement was palpable. Peering through the cobwebs and layers of dust, Campen and his team gazed upon the find of a lifetime. Between the debris and dust, the auctioneers could just about make out what looked like a treasure trove of classic cars, all tightly packed together inside the barn's cramped interior. And though it was difficult to see beyond the initial few cars at first, it soon became clear that they'd stumbled onto something huge. A gentleman collected cars for many years, and then 15 years ago, he drove this one car in the barn as the last. Then he stopped collecting, closed the door, and no one set a foot in here since, Campen explained. "It is very, very exciting and very rare to discover an untouched barn find such as this." The first cars to be retrieved from the barn were those at the front, which included various Ford Model A and Model Ts. A Ford T pickup was first out of the gate, in fact, and promisingly, its good condition hinted that the barn's haul could be a real treasure trove. Moreover, as the team worked their way through the barn, they discovered a range of vehicles dating from the 1920s to the 1950s. Among the stash were a 1939 Opel Kadett, a 1952 Ford Popular, and built in 1934, a rare Renault Celta Quattro. One of the cars had even featured in the Danish TV series Matador, which aired from 1978 to 1982. Yes, the barn was truly a sight to behold, and a veritable treasure trove for car enthusiasts. However, as it turned out, the barn wasn't the only place that the late collector had used to store his vehicles. Indeed, there were cars hidden outside and around the building, too. These were nestled away under various tarpaulin sheets, protected from the elements. It later transpired that the original owner, who died at the age of 60, had collected these cars over a 25-year period. He lived in the town of Slagelse, but owned a country home on its outskirts, where he stored his collection. Meanwhile, getting the cars out of the barn was no easy task for the auctioneers. A combination of heavy machinery and construction vehicles were used to transport them away. But first, the salvagers had to actually get the cars out into the open. In some cases, this meant having to push the vehicles by hand. In total, the barn's original owner had amassed an impressive collection of 26 classic cars, all carefully stowed away in and around the barn. His original intention had apparently been to open a car museum, but sadly, he died before achieving this dream. Now, as they brushed away the dirt and dust, the auctioneers were particularly impressed by the condition of the cars, even where the less rare vehicles were concerned. Yet, while some restoration was obviously required for many of the cars, for the most part, there were no signs of rust. In fact, most of the cars were found in a complete or almost complete state. In the YouTube video that detailed the barn's excavation, one of the auctioneers commented that one of the vehicles was missing its engine. However, he conceded that it was simply part of the game when it comes to these rare finds. In any case, once all the vehicles had been retrieved from the barn, they were sent to the auction house in Randers in central Denmark. Then they were auctioned off in November 2015 by Campen. The most notable cars in the auction included pairs of both Ford Model A's and T's, as well as a Ford Popular. However, the rarest of them all was the 1934 Renault Celta Quattro. Indeed, despite its relatively poor condition in comparison to the other cars, it was still a cause for excitement. And while the car's original owner didn't live to see his ambitions of a museum come to fruition, he would no doubt have been satisfied to see his collection attract so much admiration. The auctioneers might not have known what exactly was in that Slagle's barn, but it certainly turned out to be worth the trip.